Hey there, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to improve your SEO by paying attention to the links on your website. The links within your website are a super important part of people navigating your website. If people can't get around due to broken links, then Google and other search engines won't be able to crawl your site either, thus dropping you in the search results. In this video, we're going to go over 7 tips to improve your SEO by making sure your links are functioning properly. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description below. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. All right, let's go. Backlinks are still very important when it comes to WordPress SEO. They're used by Google for passing authority and to show that there is another relevant or important site that has supporting information. When a high authority domain links to you, it does a lot more than you might think. Brian Dean over at Backlinko analyzed over 1 million search results, and the conclusion was that backlinks are still an important ranking factor. Generally, it's a good sign if the number of referring domains linking to you is on an upward trend. This means that over time, more and more websites are linking to yours. In Brian's research, the number of unique referring domains was the strongest correlation found to high rankings. The websites that had more referring domains were the ones with higher rankings. A good tool to get an overview of your backlink profile is Ahrefs. You can see the total number of backlinks to your site, the number of referring domains, organic ranking keywords, and more. This platform's backlink notifications are also helpful. The new backlinks feature lets you see when new websites around the internet have linked to your WordPress site. Here's an example of SEJ linking to our negative SEO case study. Here's a little tip. Share the pages that link to your site on your social media channels. This helps to build social signals for them on their page, which in turn can build up their page authority. Links from the sites with higher page authority are beneficial to your WordPress SEO too, so it's a win-win. In other words, you can help yourself by sharing content from third parties that have taken the time to link to you. Never be afraid of reaching out to other bloggers and asking them to mention your outstanding post on their blog. Just like adding internal links, you should also add some external links to high-demand authority sites. This helps your WordPress SEO by letting Google know that you are linking out to high-quality content that is relevant to yours. Plus, it improves the user experience by providing your visitors or users with additional information. This can also be a great way to start conversation with other brands. If you link to another company in your post, shoot them a quick email or tweet after you publish and ask for them to share it. If they share it over their social media profiles, their posts can send more traffic your way. We use this approach a lot ourselves. We recommend adding at least 2 high domain authority external links within each piece of content. When doing so, a nice little trick to keep people on your site is to make the link open in a new tab or window. Some people might argue that they don't like this, but it can help encourage users to come back and browse your site later on, when they might have otherwise forgotten about you. In the block editor, you can set a link to open in a new tab by clicking on it, then clicking on the drop-down menu and toggling the switch. Follow these quick steps to make a link open in a new tab or window in the classic editor. Open your post or page in the classic editor, then navigate to the link you want to modify. Just like in the block editor, click on it to access the link settings. Select the pencil icon to edit the link. Next, click on the gear icon to access additional settings. Under the URL and link text fields, you'll see a checkbox labeled Open Link in a new tab. Select it to apply this feature to your link. This will add the target blank element to your link's HTML tag. The result will then look like this. You can incorporate this manually in the text editor if needed. Nobody likes broken links, including Google. There are a couple ways you can fix these broken links on your WordPress site. The first is to simply check for them in the Google Search Console. This is yet another reason why you should be using this platform. To find broken links in Google Search Console, navigate to the Coverage section. Here you'll see a report that notes pages on your site with errors and warnings, as well as content that is valid or excluded. If you click on the error box and scroll down to the details section, you'll see a list of any problems Google encountered while crawling your site. This will include 404 errors, which usually indicate broken links. By clicking the Inspect Page icon for each broken link, you can find out where these broken links are located. So you can go to your site and replace them with valid ones. Another source of crawl errors can be found in Google Search Console settings under Crawl Stats. Check for the errors in the By Response table and select each error type for more details. There are broken link plugins for WordPress as well. However, we don't recommend these as they tend to hurt the performance of your site. If you want to scan your site for broken links, it's better to do a one-time scan with a free online tool like brokenlinkcheck.com. Internal links are links that point from one page or post on your site to another page or post. They're not only key to SEO, but also to site navigation. Usually, you'll incorporate them when referring to other content you have written or when linking to your own landing pages. In short, internal links help people to navigate within your website, which can lead to more content being consumed, resulting in more time being spent on your site. They can help to establish a hierarchy of your information and structure your site. They help spread authority throughout your website by passing value through links. We always recommend adding at least 3 to 5 internal links on each post or page you write. Depending upon the length of your content, you may add even more. Follow these steps to incorporate internal links in WordPress. First, highlight the word or words you want to add your link to, also known as your anchor text. Then, click on the link button. In the classic editor, you'll find it in the main toolbar. In the block editor, you can find it in the small toolbar on the top of your paragraph block. Regardless of which editor you're using, you'll see a small text box appear when you click on the link button. In the text box, start typing the title of your internal post or page you want to link to. WordPress will supply search results suggesting available content. If you're using the classic editor, it'll look like this. In the block editor, you'll see the following. For both, you'll need to click on the title of the post or page to add the link. There are several basic types of links on the internet when it comes to WordPress SEO. By default, every link you create in WordPress is a Dofollow link. Google crawls these types of links when analyzing your site. This helps build authority and affects your rankings, since link juice is passed from the linking page. You may have heard people say that you need more backlinks. If so, they were probably referring to Dofollow links from other high authority sites. Nofollow links contain the rel attribute of nofollow, as seen here. Nofollow links tell search engine crawlers to ignore them. That is not to say that nofollow links aren't important, though. They can still generate traffic, even if they don't pass authority and influence your rankings. You can read our tutorial on different ways to add nofollow links in WordPress. Nofollow links are often used when a link is placed at the request of the linked website. This is because links pass value between pages, so this should occur naturally. Manipulating sites to link to you is against Google's guidelines, so ignoring this could cause your site to be penalized. Generally, a natural backlink profile includes a good ratio between dofollow and nofollow links. Sponsored links contain the rel attribute of sponsored, as seen here. This is used to show when a link is sponsored. Sponsored links are often used as part of paid campaigns, where the goal of the sponsored link should be about driving traffic rather than passing value from the linking page. It's against Google's guidelines to pay for links that pass value, so it's important to make sure any sponsored links use the sponsored link attribute. UGC links, or user-generated content links, contain the relation attribute of UGC, as seen here. UGC links are used to show when a link has been created by users. These are often found in blog comments and forums. A lot of WordPress bloggers and even some businesses use affiliated links on their website. Affiliate links are generally used when you want to track a commission or referral of a product or sign up between websites. Unfortunately, Google usually frowns upon affiliate links. Some sites have even been penalized for having a lot of affiliate links. To safely use these links, they should always include the sponsored or nofollow attribute. A great way to keep track of your affiliate links and always make sure that they use the sponsored attribute is to use an affiliate plugin such as Pretty Links or Thirsty Affiliates. Pretty Links enables you to create easy and short affiliate links that include the sponsored attribute and also redirect with a 301. Simply go to Pretty Links and then Options in your WordPress dashboard to enable these settings. You can select the relevant redirect type from the dropdown and select the Enable Nofollow and Sponsored checkboxes to make all of your affiliate links include the nofollow and sponsored attributes. If you scroll all the way down to the bottom of your website, you may find a couple of credits that you didn't put there. One will likely be the standard Powered by WordPress link that's applied to every WordPress site. The other is often a credit that points back to the theme's developer site. While these links aren't incorporated with bad intentions, they don't look particularly professional. Plus, links have a significant impact on your WordPress SEO. Removing any unnecessary links from your site is a best practice. As for any theme credits that may be included, you might be able to delete them via the customizer. Alternatively, you may be able to remove this link by editing your theme's footer.php file. However, this can be a little trickier, so it's best to stick with the customizer if possible. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our My Kinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. And thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.